Good morning, Sherry Stoka. How are you?
Doing well. How are you?
Doing well, Mr. Question Man. How are you today?
Doing well as well.
I understand the rain barrel in this edition of, what are we calling this thing?
What about weight loss?
What about weight loss? Part three. I understand the rain barrel is quite full of questions.
You are correct, sir.
Folks can chime in at 262-694-1050, so let's not waste any more time. Mr. Question Man, if you could fire off number one, please.
This one hits on a couple of different topics that are pretty interesting. Says, my friend is big on doing a juice cleanse periodically, and I've been reading a lot lately about the need to detox my body. But in discussing with my husband, he says, I don't need any special detox methods. That's what my liver and kidneys are for. So, Sherry, do you have any advice or guidance on cleanses and detoxing the body?
I definitely do. So, okay. I guess just in summary, every single human on the planet needs to detox. So our body does have detox organs. However, you can imagine over time, these organs get congested, you know, over time they don't function properly. And a lot of it is driven by lifestyle and, you know, the choices that we make. But, you know, the liver is, you know, people are starting to develop these liver conditions. Gallbladders are being removed because, you know, simply they're not working correctly. It's because they're overwhelmed and they're overworked. So the woman is correct. You know, she definitely is on the right track with doing a detox every now and then because it's so crucial to good health.
What about a juice cleanse specifically? Something we should be watching out for with those?
Yeah, I mean, there are some very good juice cleanses out there, you know, depending on the length of time. You know, for me, if I'm going to be doing something really aggressive, I'm going to want to probably do more of a fasting cleanse, you know, kind of cleansing naturally versus, you know, still feeding your body with a lot of sugar, you know, because that's kind of the tricky thing with cleanses. You know, you can be getting a lot of sugars and still spiking those blood sugars and that type of thing. But don't get me wrong, there's probably some really good ones out there. I would recommend doing more of a short term than a long term, because that kind of can create some other problems if not done correctly.
All right, hope that answers that question, Mr. Question Man.
The next one is short and sweet, naturally sweet. What are the best foods to eat that keep you full?
That's a good one. Everybody wants to be full, but we want to lose weight.
Yeah, exactly. And everyone experiences fullness very differently. We know that from our genetics and the genetic testing that we do. But, you know, just in general, foods that keep you full are high fiber foods for sure. You know, vegetables, you know, cruciferous vegetables, really healthy, you know, whole grains because they have a ton of fiber. But I will say for the most part, good leaner proteins, healthy fats, not like, you know, processed fats that are in fatty foods, but healthy fats and again, you know, the high fiber. Now, the carbohydrates, you know, the sugars, those are going to keep you hungry. I mean, we know that. And I will mention one thing. This isn't always just about the food. It's about how often we're eating. It's about how we eat our food. You know, are we chewing our food and allowing those signals to happen? You know, are we sitting down and eating and allowing those signals to happen? So kind of thinking, you know, outside of just the food all the time, it's kind of like those habits and how we're consuming the meals.
All right, Sherry, I have a quick question. Summertime, the living's easy. The summer fruits are here. A lot of people eat more fruit in the summertime. How much fruit is too much fruit?
Yeah, so the recommendation is 2 to 3 fruits a day. So, you know, anything more than that is probably just not necessary and just added sugars and calories. So I would say 2 for most people is all you need.
All right, there's some that are worse than others.
You know, I think there's definitely going to be ones that are like what we consider more higher glycemic load. So they impact the sugar or the blood sugars more quickly. You know, some, I would stick to the fruits that are more, that have more fiber because they help control those spikes. So fruits with skin, you know, bananas get kind of a bad rap. They don't have the skin, you know, they do have a good amount of fiber. So I think just in general, I think just getting a variety watching the amount is probably more important than, you know, specific, you know, honing in on specific ones.
All right. Time for one more, Mr. Question Man.
This listener says, I'm busy and having trouble meal prepping. Do you have some pointers on a successful meal planning / prepping plan?
Oh, you know, that's such a great question, but it's so hard to answer because it's really working with everyone individually. Like, I'm constantly trying to come up with my own plan, but I would say, you know, really trying to come up with recipes that you really enjoy, creating those grocery lists and picking days that you're going to focus on meal prepping. You know, with the days that you're going to cut, you're going to cook, you're going to put, you know, cook in, you know, more than you need and freeze. So I think just kind of thinking through that and picking those specific days helps a lot of people. But again, everyone has their own technique. But it is a challenge, you know, because we're all busy for sure.
All right. Keep those questions coming. Peter at WLIP.com. And we'll continue next week. Mr. Question Man will refill the rain barrel with all kinds of weight loss questions for you. Sherry Stoka, Weightless MD and Wellness, Southport Plaza in Kenosha. The first visit's absolutely free. How do we find out more?
Yes. So our phone number is 262-226-2046, or you can go to our website at weightlossmd.com.
Check out the Facebook page. Check out the podcast with Sherry and sometimes Ron. Is it officially sometimes Ron now? Sherry Stoka, Weightless MD and Wellness. Thanks so much. Have a great week.
Thank you. You too.